Welcome back, fast food fanatics, to episode 2 of Quick Bite Review. We're over at Taco Bel, and today we're going to be reviewing the grilled cheese burrito, the nacho double crunch taco, and the pineapple whip freeze. Let's crush some calories. So up first, we got the nacho double crunch taco. Let's see how it tastes. So right away, definitely get the double crunch from it. It's kind of lacking a little bit on the nacho aspect of it. You definitely get the cheese, but there's not a ton of nacho flavor coming through. This was a limited release in 2016. The only difference now is that it's a dollar, and I understand exactly why it's a dollar. Best of both worlds scenario, if you're a fan of their soft tacos or their crunchy tacos, I get why they put the red strips in there. It adds that extra layer of crunch, that extra layer of texture, but there's nothing about this taco that screams nacho or why you would really pay more than a dollar for it. But that being said, it's a no-brainer for anybody who's a taco fan. For a dollar, you can't beat it. But would I go out of my way to get it again? Probably not. So next up, we have the pineapple whip freeze. What this is Taco Bel's take on a Dole Whip. It's supposed to be a little bit creamier than just their regular pineapple freeze, which is more like a slushy. This is supposed to have a vanilla cream in there, and I'm really curious to see how it tastes because I'm a big fan of the Dole Whips. Really tasty. Don't know whether or not you guys can kind of see that, how it's setting up on the bottom there. It's definitely nowhere near as creamy as a Dole Whip. It's pretty much the second that it touches your hand, it starts to melt already because of the slush factor of it. But it is very, very tasty. I would absolutely get this again. There's a ton of creaminess in there. The vanilla doesn't overpower the pineapple. The pineapple's a little artificial, but in a good way. And for about 250 calories and for the value of it, you can't go wrong. Also, what's nice about these is that if you get the pineapple freezes without the whip, I'm not sure, they might do it with the whip if you ask, but they have them in pineapple, strawberry, and if I'm not mistaken, Baja Blast. And anybody who's ever been to a Taco Bel, you know how good Baja Blast is. So I imagine in a slushy form, it's even better. Last up, we have the grilled cheese burrito. I'm looking forward to this. I heard from a few people that this is really good. So, little backstory on this. We went in, I ordered the grilled cheese burrito, which is a current thing that they're pumping out at Taco Bel. They gave it to me, and it's supposed to have cheese on top of it. That's kind of the marketing point, right? And it didn't. So we went back in, and then this Taco Bel just threw cheese on it, and then what I imagine is probably either microwaved it or something to that effect, and then wrapped it really quickly so that literally all of the cheese that they just put on it stuck to this. So your mileage may vary on this, but just, you know, something to keep in mind when you order this. Lack of the cheese being on top of it aside, it is a good burrito. There's little red tortilla strips in there. I don't know that that really adds anything to this burrito, because if you're going to put those inside of something that's so highly saturated in meat and cheese and rice and sauce, the crunch factor that these would add is basically non-existent. But the flavor of this is very good. It's reminiscent of kind of a cross between maybe their five-layer burrito on their value menu and then the cheesy bean and rice burrito sans the beans. The sauce and everything that they have in there is really tasty. It's sad that I couldn't kind of experience it with all the cheese that's supposed to be on top of it. Would I really go out of my way to get this? I don't think so. The irony is that both of these miss in the opposite direction. So there's not enough nacho flavor in that double crunch taco, but there is tons of crunch in a really good and appealing way that adds a nice mouthfeel and texture. Now this is supposed to be a grilled cheese burrito, and when you kind of think of something like that, you just kind of imagine a ton of cheese flavor. And while there is like a good amount of cheese flavor, it seems like it kind of lacks any textural component that you would get from a good grilled cheese. So, final review. Nothing that really blew my mind here as far as the food was concerned, but pleasantly surprised. If you're gonna go with any of the three that I reviewed here, I'd say go with the pineapple whip freeze. It's not exactly like you would expect as far as the Dole Whip is concerned, but super refreshing, really tasty. The dollar for the double crunch nacho cheese taco that they're promoting is a great deal for a dollar. I would absolutely recommend anybody who's a fan of their soft tacos to get it, because you can't beat it for a buck, but nothing special there. The flavor and the texture of everything that was going on inside of the grilled cheese burrito was good in theory, not in practice. If anybody goes in with low expectations of it not being a grilled cheese burrito, you'll probably be pleasantly surprised and actually enjoy it. My mileage varied on this one. I think just the overall presentation, how it was given to me, kind of sullied the experience for me. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of Quick Bite Review. If there's anything special you guys want to see me review in the upcoming episodes, let us know down in the comments section, and I'll catch you on the next one.